Everyone, David Bumble back with Talking Sasquatch. Oh, amazing videos on his channel. Talking Sasquatch, I'm going to have to get used to pronouncing that properly. Welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
So what are we going to talk about today? Because you got another amazing demo.
Yeah, so one of the things you can do with an NRF board on the Flipper Zero is what's known as mouse jacking. It's mostly been patched out of stuff, but if you have the right hardware, you can actually basically take control of a keyboard or a mouse that's attached to a susceptible dongle.
That's amazing. So we're using Bluetooth, right, to control the mouse?
So actually, this is going to be using just the old school, you need NRF for it. It's the old 2.4 gigahertz ones. It's possible on Bluetooth, but the problem you run into is you have to pair it. So pairing Bluetooth inherently has some issues. There are some older Bluetooth dongles that actually pair directly to the dongle. So you don't actually have to do it on the PC itself. But I don't have one of those right now, but I do have a susceptible. It's an old Logitech unifying receiver.
So do you need something with the Flipper Zero, like a special board or something?
Yeah, so for this one, we're going to use a NRF board right here. So this is just one of mine. It's a fancy one made by AWOC. But, I mean, a normal NRF, let me see, I just got one plugged in over here. This is kind of a normal just NRF right there. Nothing particularly fancy. If you want to run the wires, it's, I want to say, 5 wires of this hooks up to the Flipper, and you can do it the old-fashioned way. You know, nowadays, all the creators of the GPIO boards are making cool stuff, so you know, might as well use the cool stuff.
So we'll have another video, hopefully, is that right, where you're going to talk about some of your favorite boards and like what the capabilities are, because some of the questions I get is like, what is the difference between this board and this board? You know, there's all these boards. And
I've got a stack of them for you. Great. Absolutely. I even had Rabbit Labs overnighted me something. So yeah, we got some cool stuff.
Great. So we'll cover that in a separate video. So show us about the, what is it, NRF mouse jacking, right?
Yeah, so it's an NRF 24. So yeah, basically, and I've got right here, and I mean, I know it's not very interesting, but it's a Logitech unifying receiver. I was lucky enough to actually own a really old keyboard. So actually, for the sake of argument here, this nasty, crusty old keyboard that's got way too many hours on it, this is actually what made this whole project work. What was really funny is when I was actually doing it the first time, I bought 3 different unifying receivers or mice from Amazon because they were all on Bastille Research's list of susceptible devices. None of them worked. They all had patched firmware. So I luckily had one of these. I dug it out of literally a box full of stuff and plugged it in, got sniffing away at it, and it just worked. So it was pretty cool.
That's great. So enough talking. Show us the demo, man.
So what we're going to do is I've got my Flipper here. And again, if you haven't seen my cool blue with the RGB mod, that's kind of nice. Fun. And yeah, I've got the AWOC NRF 24. It's the V3. It's the third version of this he's had. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug this in, which is, there we go, easier than it looks. And I'm going to go ahead and take this dongle, plug it into my computer. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to, so there's an application on the Flipper in your GPIO. So right now I'm using the latest Extreme firmware. It's got all the applications I need for this, and it's got support for the RGB backlight, which is, you know, it's a really cool mod if anybody wants to try that. It's a little tricky, and some people have had problems with it, but let's see. Let's go down to NRF 24, and then we'll flip right over to the screen. Plug this in, and then we're going to hop over to QFlipper. And I'll show you what's going on here. So 1, 2, 3. So now we're over to the desktop, and this is the NRF 24 sniffer. So this is really, it's just going to go through and it's going to effectively sniff for NRF signals for a susceptible keyboard. I'm going to turn the sample time down. So if you turn the higher the sample time, basically the longer it takes, but the more accurate it can be. I'm going to set it to 2500 milliseconds. I'm going to open up Notepad so you can see what's going on as well. Because what I have to do while I'm doing this, let me grab my keyboard, is basically just use the keyboard. So more or less, the whole project is just going to be me. You're going to be watching me clicking on a keyboard for about a minute. It's super fun, but at some point this will pop up. And with any luck, let's make it so you can see everything at the same time. It's going to pop up as found in that bottom corner. Now, again, it's not as fun watching as it is to do, but at some point in time, we'll get the keyboard to show up. So yeah, there we go. We're still sniffing, but we found our dongle right there. So that is absolutely fantastic. One thing I do want to mention is that if you try to do this on your own, don't expect it to go quickly or even all like work at all. There are a lot of devices that are supposed to work with this and they don't. And even this dongle, which I've paired over and over and over again, the first time we did it, we spent an hour getting it to work. We got a little bit lucky that it actually showed up as quickly as it did here, but you know, don't expect instant results. It's all this hacking stuff takes a little bit of time sometimes. So now that we've got that, I'm going to actually show you how this works. So let's clear this. Actually, we can close Notepad entirely. We don't need to. Don't save. Who wants that? All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back, and that's going to actually save our address file into the right location already, because that's the way I've got it set up. So we're just going to open up the NRF24 mouse jacker. So what this is going to do, it's already got the address in there. So this is going to load a payload. Whoops, hold on. Connect NRF24 to GPIO. I have to replug my board in. Sometimes this happens. It's fun. There we go. So what it's going to do, this is going to run a bad USB payload. One thing to keep in mind is, in particular, NRF24 is slow. It's not a very quick protocol. So if you are trying to do something like run a bad USB script, especially one that actually is running code into PowerShell, you want to make sure your delays are set right. You want to make sure nothing's overly ambitious. Let me run this demo and you'll kind of get the idea for how that all works. So we're going to hop over and just going to run the Windows demo, and it's running Ducky scripts. It's opening up Notepad right now, and this is just the normal Flipper Zero bad USB demo.
That's great. So just so that everyone understands what you're doing here, the Flipper Zero is not connected to the computer physically. It's going through NRF, right?
So what it's doing right now is using NRF, correct? It's hooked up to the computer physically simply so I can share the video. Or this, you know, share the screen of it. But yeah, that's basically, this is all wireless. I can disconnect it entirely and run the exact same thing the exact same way. Yeah, it's really, it's a pretty cool thing. Again, this is why there are some people actually selling the actual dongles. There's, I think a few people on Etsy are selling susceptible dongles right out the box. They even have the address written on it. So you can go through in Flipper Zero and just make a text file with the address on it, drop it in the right folder, and it'll work. What's cool about this is that you plug the dongle into the computer, nothing happens. Then you have control of it with the NRF board. Depending upon how good your antenna is, depends on the range. It's not supposed to have really, really good range. But again, if you put a big enough antenna on it, you get better range. But yeah, it's a pretty good way to just kind of drop in. You can obviously run code that way. And yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty powerful.
You'll have to give us the links for those Etsy people. So Etsy, how do you say, what are they called? Etsy shops, right?
Yeah, it's an Etsy shop or a Tendy shop, one of the online shops. But yeah, I could definitely do that.
So I'll link those below. Again, we've got another video coming up where Nate tells us about all of his like cool dongles and stuff that he recommends. So I'll link that below. It might come after this video, but if you're watching this later, then have a look at that. And don't forget to go and subscribe. Tell us about your channel again.
So yeah, channel's Talking Sasquatch. Again, Talking Sasquatch, Sasquach. There's no T in it. Whole story behind it, but I won't bore you with that one again. I do a lot of Flipper Zero content. I do tutorials on pretty much everything I figured out how to do. I've got a tutorial on it, including even things like doing the RGB mod with the screen. We've got clear cases. So I had just made a video on clear cases. We do flashing. I've got videos even on just how to install Python because people kept asking me questions about it. Anything Flipper, I've pretty much got a video on it. And if I don't, probably is in the works.
So you've mentioned many times on your channel, and you've mentioned it here as well, about a Discord. Is this your Discord, or what Discord are you referring to?
Yeah, no, actually, I have my own Discord. We can link below if you want. And yeah, it's a few thousand members at this point. And what's really cool is just like it's Flipper Zero is the community, right? So the device is the device and it does what it does, but it's everybody in the community that's really kind of made it what it is. So way back when I started the whole, you know, YouTube thing, a guy named Sticks hopped over and said, "Hey, you want to make a Discord?" And I was like, "Oh, you know, whatever." But it turns out that's where a majority of people just see my content and they hop into my Discord. They're like, "Hey, I've figured this out, or I know how to do this, check it out. So that's actually how like a lot of content comes from, is just from that community. And that's why I love the Flipper Zero community so much.
Go and check out Nate's YouTube channel. Obviously a whole bunch of content there, from like how to get started to more complex stuff. I've learned some stuff, fantastic things there. Go and show the love and subscribe. Nate, thanks so much.
Hey, appreciate you having me.